Breaking developments tonight in that manhunt that's now gone nationwide. A cop killer on the loose. This new image of the suspect dressed for a war reenactment, looking through the scope of that rifle. Entire communities bolting their doors, students kept home for a third day. And Friday night lights gone dark. ABC's Lindsay Janis on the ground.
Tonight, this community on lockdown. Schools closed, soccer practice canceled, football games rescheduled as people stick close to home and to each other. Choppers hovering overhead. Police sweeping these dense woods for any sign of Eric Frain. Last night, racing towards potential sightings, closing roads, even evacuating homes. And today, this image giving us a sense of why police and neighbors are so afraid. The 31-year-old in military gear, an expert marksman who participated in war games like these seen on YouTube. People we met trying to retain a sense of normalcy, but clearly on edge.
Do you feel like a hostage in your own home?
No. I just can't. I refuse to feel like that.
Donna Dunning has lived in this area her entire life.
Have you thought about what you'd do if you looked out the window and saw him in your yard?
I have a machete right by the door.
Taking us inside to see it.
I have a machete.
That makes me want to back up.
Fred and Kat DiMercurio say they're also armed. Fred's gun today in his back pocket.
I don't know how to say this, but we sleep with our guns.
David, as this community waits, more than 200 law enforcement officials are combing the area using police dogs and the latest technology, racing to stop this man before he strikes again.